shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O ye gates. Even lift them up, ye everlasting doors. And the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts, he is the King of glory. Selah. May the Lord add blessing to the reader, to the hearers, most of all to the doers of his word. As I prepare to turn this over to our officiant this morning, listen, Sister Sandra was a celebrator. She was a praiser. She was one that loved God, and she was saved. We are not here for a sad occasion, though we may feel sad, but this is a time of homegoing and celebration. So I want us to take a moment right here as Pastor Chase comes and put our hands together and bless the Lord of our lives right now. Let's do that. Put your hands together and bless him. Bless the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Great. Good morning to all of you. You may be seated for just a moment. We're here today to mark the to celebrate the life of Sandra Patricia Cutting, 1958 to 2024. Sandra departed this life on February the 27th at 6:38 p.m. I would like to extend my deepest condolences to the family on behalf of Corinne, Kendall, and Kaylin, myself, and the entire Barbadian community here in Southern California. You have our deepest sympathy and support with our sincere prayer that you'll find God to be your strength in these hours and days and weeks to come. And our prayer that you will go from strength to strength. Sandra was a pillar in the Barbadian community. She was a pillar in the Compton Unified School District. She was a significant pillar at King's Dominion Life Center Church, where she attended. And she also served and was a longtime member at the Church of God Pentecostal Inglewood. She was the godmother of my two daughters and cared for them when they were young. She was much beloved, and we've already missed her. But Sandra fell asleep in Christ. That's how the Apostle Paul describes her. That she fell asleep in Christ. It is important for those of us who remain and who will live on for yet a while longer to make sure that when you fall asleep, pass away. Cindy, Zach, Miracle, Sacred, when they ask you, what happened to Mom? What happened to Granny? That's your answer. She fell asleep in Christ. That's how you speak of her. Because the apostle calls us to know that the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of the archangel, and with the call of God, and dead in Christ will rise first. This tells me that Sandra has an appointment with the trumpet call. Clavier, After Sandra passed away, the week that followed, you received calls from this doctor's office and that doctor's office, trying to find out why Sandra did not keep her appointment. But now you have a good answer. And now Sandra has a greater appointment. She has an appointment with the trumpet call of God. Yes, she does. And I can assure you that she will not miss that appointment, because the Lord himself will descend and come and get her. Can you clap your hands for that? Your presence here today is a witness. It is a testimony to the fact that somewhere along Sandra's journey, she touched your life in a significant way. So if you praise God for the grace that was in her, for the gifts that came forth from her, for the love that she shared, if you praise God for the life that she lived and the example that she left, then would you put your hands together and give God a great big hand of praise? I'm going to ask you if you'll please stand for the hymn of affirmation this morning. The family may remain seated if you wish, or you can stand with us. Here is, I'm going to ask you, the hymn, the words to the hymn will be on the board. I'm going to ask you, I know that many of you are not confident in all your singing skills, and some of you only sing in the shower. But I'm going to ask you to leave all of that this morning behind. And I'm going to ask for all of you to join in singing this hymn with us this morning. Sing loud enough so that the person next to you can hear. Sing loud enough that perhaps some of these pastors here on the pulpit with me will invite you to come to church tomorrow morning. Let's raise this hymn, and as we sing, would you release your faith and let your strength come to you? Let your faith reach up. My faith is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. The organist will lead us in the song.
My
everyone.
Hope is built on nothing
everyone, please.
Less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust a but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand.
My open sea. receive Pastor Renty, who will come with the invocation.
Our love and prayers to the family. Let us bow our heads and pray. Dear Lord God, as Christ believers, we gather who are filled with Holy Spirit, recognizing that it is your Holy Spirit that is the comforter. We receive him because we know him. We know your Son, Jesus Christ. And so, Father, as we have gathered for this occasion, we ask that you, by your Spirit, would comfort, strengthen, lead, guide, as only you can. You are the good, good Father. And we know that you recognize and you love your children. And so, Father, as we celebrate the life of our dear sister, we thank you right now that you would even cause your Holy Spirit right now to even come in and flood this place where we are sitting, as it were on the day of Pentecost. Fill this place, Lord God, as we celebrate the life of your sister, Lord, of your daughter, our sister. Father, we thank you right now for the presence, your presence. Your presence that gives peace that surpasses all understanding. Oh, gracious Father, we thank you right now. Do it again, we pray in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you right now that even now that a rushing wind would flow in this place where we are sinning, with the understanding, Lord God, that we who know you in the pardon of our sins, because we have received your Son, Jesus Christ. He is the baptizer in the Holy Spirit. He is our Savior. He is our deliverer. He is our healer. And he is our soon coming King. So we thank you, Lord God, even though at this hour there may be grief. Oh, but we do not grieve as others grieve, Lord God. For we know from the Apostle Paul, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And Father, we look for that day, that resurrection morning, even as we celebrate the resurrection of your Savior. We look for that morning, Lord God. The old saints call it a great getting up morning. We thank you, Lord God. Father, we thank you right now. We look forward to your coming, your soon coming, for there is none like you. But while we wait, Lord God, you said occupy. So, Father, while we wait and while we strengthen one another, while we encourage one another, while we show love toward one another, Father, we thank you. You are in our midst and you are moving. Hallelujah, Lord God. You said in your word, you never leave us nor forsake us, but you'll be with us even to the end of the world. You're with us now. And Father, right now, we lean upon your everlasting armor. Lord God, we thank you for strength. We thank you, oh my God, we thank you for comfort. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We thank you, Lord God, for there is none like you. So, Father God, is with the utmost humility, we thank you and praise you, and we adore you, and we lift up our hands and say, thank you, Lord God, for being here right now. Thank you, Lord God, for this next season. You will show yourself strong. We thank you to the family, to the loved ones and friends that gather. We thank you right now, Lord God. You have caused them, help them to navigate through this season as only you can. Father God, the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost given unto us. And so we thank you and praise you in the matchless mighty name of Jesus. We know that it is so. We know that it is so according to your word. In Jesus' name, let the people of God say amen, amen, and amen.
Amen. Come on and say hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Praise God. I am joined here on the pulpit with several distinguished men and women of God. First of all, we have the founder and pastor of the Church of God Pentecostal of Inglewood. He is also the presiding bishop of the Churches of God Pentecostal that are everywhere. None other than the Bishop Dr. Johnny J. Young. Please put your hands together and receive him. We also have the pastor of King's Dominion Life Center Church, Bishop Dr. T. Allen Moore, who is our preacher of the hour. Can you put your hands together for him? You also just heard from Pastor Dr. Anthony Renty. Amen. And we also have with us one of Bishop Moore's leadership team, Elder Peggy Kanzler. Praise God for her. As I look out, there are other men and women of God who are present with us. Amen. I think I recognize Reverend Chase, the first assistant at Holman United Methodist Church. And I'm sure that if I look closely, I'll find many more. Can you put your hands together and thank God for these men and women of God? I believe that Miss Margot will come with the reading of the scripture, and she will be followed by Anita Thornhill, or Anita will, Annick will come first, followed by Sister Mark. Scripture.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Margot Hill. I'm the second eldest sister of Sandra. And this morning, I'm going to try to read the scripture. It's taken from Romans chapter 8, verses 31-39. What shall we say then to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him to be for us all. I'm sorry, the light is so dark, I can't see.
Yeah.
Yes, I can't see. What shall we say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is justified. Who is he that who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us? Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are counted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Here endeth the scripture.
Good morning to the church. I am Regina Brathwaite, and I am the last of the sisters. I'm reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 20-26. But now is Christ risen from the dead, and became the first fruits of them that slept. For since by man came death, by man came also the resurrection. every man. The first fruits. Afterward, they that are in up the kingdom to God, even to the Father. For he must reign till he hath put all enemies under his feet. The last enemy that shall be destroyed is death. This is the word of the Lord.
Tyrone Fields is going to come and render a solo at this time.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Let's give God a great big hand praise in this place. Hallelujah. I just came and stopped by this morning to encourage you to stand. I know that you're going through. I know it may be tough. I know the situations may get rough. But if you can just stand and hold on to God, he'll see you through. Amen. What do you do when you've done all you can and seems like it's never enough? And what do you say when your friends turn away and you're all alone? And what do you give when you're giving your all and seems like you can't make it through? Well, you just stand when there is nothing left to do. You just stand, watch the Lord see you through. Yes, after you've done all you can, you just stand. And how do you handle the guilt of your past? Tell me, how do you deal with the shame? And how can you smile when your heart has been broken and filled with pain? Tell me, what do you do when you've done all you can and seems like you can't make it through? Well, you just stand when there is nothing left to do. You just stand, watch the Lord see you through. Yes, after you've done all you can, you just stand. And endure. Be not entangled with that bondage again. You just stand and endure. For God has a purpose. Yes, God has a plan. Tell me, what do you do when you've done all you can, and seems like you can't make it through, well, you just stand, stand, stand. Don't you dare give up. Through the storm and through the rain and through the hurt, stand through the pain. Don't you bow, don't you bend, don't give up, no, don't give in. Just hold on, just be strong. God will step in, and it won't be long, no, no. It's after you've done all you can. Oh, after you've done all that you can. After you've gone through the storm. Yeah. And after you've gone through the rain. You pray. You prayed and cried. You prayed and cried. You prayed and cried. Oh, yeah. After you've done all you can, you just stand. Oh. Just stand.
Absolutely right. You're found standing with the word of the Lord in your mouth. I promise you, you'll never be defeated. Amen. So long as you're standing with the word. Amen. Come on and give a brother Kylo on the way. I also this morning want to acknowledge, I believe he's here or on the premises at least, the senior pastor of this church. The senior pastor of this church, Crenshaw United Methodist. He's been very supportive of our Barbadian community. He has extended his assistance to us on more than one occasion. I don't think that he's in the service, but I believe that he's on the premises. Reverend Royce V. Porter, Sr., could you please acknowledge him? Amen. Come on, you can do better than that. Yes. He's been very gracious to us as the Barbadian community, and we thank him for doing so on more than one occasion. Annette Thornhill, Sandra's sister, will come to read the obituary at this time.
God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Sandra P. Cutting, founder and past president of the Barbados Association of Southern California, was born on Spooners Hill, St. Michael, Barbados, West Indies. She was the third of five children born to Olga Agnetha Thornhill and Kenneth Durwood. I'm the first, Arnett Thornhill. She began her educational path at Grace Hill Primary School and continued to St. Leonard Secondary Girls School. Her first job was in the retail grocery industry, where she met her future husband, Clavier Cutting, whom she later married and migrated to the United States in 1985. In 1986, she attended United College of Business, graduating with a diploma in secretarial science. Her newly acquired skills and knowledge positioned her for employment in the banking industry as a quality control clerk in the mortgage department at the Bank of California, then at First Interstate Bank as a junior loan processor. Sandra changed careers from banking to education in 2002. She was employed by the Compton Unified School District as a school secretary slash office manager until her passing in February 2024. Never one to rest on her laurels and on a quest to further her education, Sandra attended Los Angeles City College and Southwest College to pursue a business degree. She later changed her major and transferred to Ministerial Training Institute, Inglewood, California, graduating with an associate degree in biblical studies. Sandra was a dedicated and positive Barbadian who freely and effortlessly gave of herself. Despite the hurdles she encountered, she was not fearful due to her Christian upbringing and belief in the teachings of the prophet Micah 6, verse 8, to do justly and to love mercy and walk humbly with God. Sandra's love of God empowered her to serve his church in several capacities, including office manager, youth president, and in several lay ministries at the Church of God Pentecostal in Inglewood. She was a dedicated member and usher at King's Dominion Life Center Ministries International, Los Angeles, California. Over the years, Sandra was affiliated with many life-changing organizations and made significant contribution to her community. She was a member of the Barbados Association of Atlanta and a member and treasurer of the Barbados Association of California. Sandra, for many years, supported the Caribbean Carnival in Los Angeles and even managed her own costume band. Sandra was well known and highly respected in the community. It was that popularity and respect by fellow Barbadians that prompted her to answer the call to start an organization that represented the Barbadian community in Southern California. She approached fellow Barbadians June Small Lashley and Gregory Chase, and from that meeting, the Barbados Association of Southern California, the West Coast's premier Barbadian organization, became a reality. Sandra served 2 terms as the first president of BAS, then as a member of the board when BAS celebrated its milestone 10-year anniversary in 2023. Her brainchild is poised to be one of the most influential Caribbean organizations in terms of its social, cultural, and societal impact. Her numerous awards include the BASC Golden Trident Award for Community Service in 2019, and from the Compton School District, the Classified Staff of the Year in 2023. What a testimony of her leadership, dedication, and commitment. This multi-talented Scorpio, like me, was equally at ease running the organization as she was playing the lead role in all the dramatic presentations of the Barbados Association of Southern California. Her signature performance was the nut seller in Bajan Market Scene, and what a nut seller she was. Sandra is the proud parent of Zachary and Cindy and doting grandmother to Sacred Avery Miracle and a foster parent to many over the years. The entire Caribbean community becomes the beneficiary of her vision, vigor, advocacy, perseverance, and caring sensitivity, and is better as a result of her impact. On February 27, 2024, following a brief illness, surrounded by her loving family and friends, Sandra peacefully transitioned to meet her Lord and Savior. She leaves behind many to honor her and cherish her memory. Daughter, Cindy Mosley. Son, Zachary Cutting. Grandchildren, Sacred, Avery, and Miracle. Sisters Arnett, Margot Hill, brother-in-law DeCarlo Hill, Regina Brathwaite, brother-in-law Norton Brathwaite, Brother Michael Thornhill, and a host of nieces, nephews, cousins, officers, and members of Bass, extended family, and friends. Eternal rest grant unto Sandra, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. And as she would say to me whenever we got off the phone together, bye, sis. Talk to you later.
Come on, give God a hand praise, everybody. Come on, clap your hand, all you people. Shout with the voice of triumph, shout with the voice of praise. Come on, give God a hand praise. Hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we rejoice and be glad in this great day. And some is, oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Yes. And I understand that we're in a celebration. And there's some hand clapping, foot stomping in the celebration. Put your hand together again for a celebration. And I'm happy that I don't see no time limit, so I have 32 minutes. I'm saying that I would like to say to the pulpit today, to Bishop Moore and to Pastor Chase and all of you that are here today, I am so honored to be here and thanking you for allowing me this space to be on this service today. This Cutting family is no stranger to me. I had the personal privilege of being the pastor of Sandra and the entire family in 1982.
Amen.
Amen. And you didn't notice, I didn't stand with the Barbados Association, but I'm an honorary member of the Barbados Association because I had a trip to Barbados by Minister Cutting and Sandra. And Sandra was an outstanding member of the church. For 12 years, she served in many positions in the church. She became our office manager. And anytime somebody working out church, the office manager free, they moved to another job, make money. So that's how she got to Compton and start making money. She was trained well in our office. She worked as the youth president. She worked as our traveling consultant. And we was going in big numbers to the youth meeting in Congo. And the convocation, and she had all that lined up with our airlines and our hotels, and Zach got baptized in Barbados, and we are so blessed to know today. I want to say to this family, to be absent from the body,
yes, sir,
is to be present with the Lord. And we today, I want you to know that the Church of God Pentecostal have you in our prayers. I would like for everyone that ever been a member of the Church of God Pentecostal who is there now, please stand if you're in this building today. And anyone here, we have some people stand. Look around. Look around. Amen. Have been a member of the Church of God Pentecostal. And we thank God for all of you. Thank God. I see a friend there in the family. She said, she was so cordial to me in Barbados. She said, yes, Mother Peace. Thank good to see you today. And God bless all of you. And we had an early meeting this morning. I have another 12:30 meeting today. But I could not miss being here today to say to you to look to the hills which come at your help. It will help us in the Lord. God bless you.
Thank you, Bishop. Thank you so very much. Do we have a representative from the Compton Unified School District to speak at this time? Come Come on and put your hands together and receive our brother.
Good morning. Good morning, everyone. My name is Larry Natividad. I'm the proud principal at Compton High School, and we had the privilege of working with her. This is my second year here, and I see a variety of staff members here, and I cannot impress on you all how important she was to us and how much she loved Compton High School and the staff, and especially the scholars. She gave her love and her utmost attention to all of our staff members. She was very happy when she was working. She stayed very late at night, even though I told her to go home and spend time with her family, and she did spend time with her family, with Miracle. We actually saw Miracle grow up in the past couple of years here at Compton High. So I cannot tell you enough how grateful we all are to be in the privilege and spirit of Miss Sandra Cutting. And I just want to thank you for involving us and for letting us be part of your family today. So on behalf of Compton High School, we want to thank you and we want to honor Miss Cutting today and forevermore. In fact, I got to tell you something. So Compton High School, we are a community school, and we help all of our scholars, especially those that are homeless and foster, and anyone that wants something in terms of clothing or in terms of resources. Our community resource administrator, Mr. Watkins, who is, I don't think he's here today, but I want to share, we want to share his voice, that we had a closet of clothes, new clothes, that we want to donate to our students, and now we fondly call it Cutting's Closet. It is. So that was born out of the love of Miss Cutting and the love that our scholars and our faculty have for your beloved sister and mother and friend and colleague and community organizer. Forevermore, we will have Cutting's Closet at Compton High School. So thank you very much.
Now, I am glad that you said what you said, sir, because it gives me the opportunity to release you. I was very upset with you for making Sandra work those long hours. And I wondered, why is Sandra coming home 7, 8, 9 o'clock? I thought, that principal must be some slave driver, but now I know it wasn't you. So thank you. I release you. And I wish you well. My name is Gregory Chase. I am fortunate to be the president of the Barbados Association of Southern California. I'm not going to speak long. We have plenty to do. But we, on behalf of the Barbados Association, we just want to offer this resolution for Sandra to the family. Whereas Sandra Patricia was a longtime resident of Los Angeles, and whereas Sandra was visionary mover and co-founder of the Barbados Association of Southern California, an organization that truly represents the Barbadian diaspora in Southern California, and that she served with distinction as its first president. And whereas Sandra championed the annual bus ride and the annual mix and mingle from their inception, and was twice re-elected to the board, and was a board member at the time of her passing,
And whereas Sandra was the custodian and maintainer of the association's decedent registry, now, therefore, be it resolved that per unanimous consent of the governing board of the Barbados Association of Southern California, Sandra Patricia Cutting shall be permanently named to the board as board member emeritus. That is proper. And be it further resolved that the passing of Sandra Patricia Cutting on February the 24th or the 27th of 2020 shall now be memorialized in perpetuity in the decedent registry of the Barbados Association of Southern California. And we'll present this resolution to the family this day, March the 23rd, 2024, Los Angeles. Yours truly, the President, Greg Chase. Can you give the family a hand? Yes. We also have with us another distinguished gentleman here this morning, the president of the Citizens and Friends of Trinidad, Mr. Vince Samuels. Come on and give him a hand as he comes.
Hello, good day all. Like Sandra would say, how are you doing? Whenever Sandra would see me, she would say, how are you doing? I would like each and every one of you to look at the person next to you and ask them, how are you doing? My name is Vincent Samuel, and I'm the newly elected president of Citizens and Friends of Trinidad and Tobago, a 501c3 nonprofit organization here in California. And I'm here, I'll be taking two positions, one as the president, and then I'm gonna say a few words on some of the good and bad times that I've had shared with Sandra. For the organization, Sandra supported us in every way she can. When she could help, when she could attend, she can sell tickets to help our nonprofit organization. And on behalf of the organization, Citizens and Friends of Trinidad and Tobago, members extend our deepest sympathy to the family on the loss of your loved one, Sandra Patricia Cutting. Though your smile and household voice are gone forever, and your hands we cannot touch, still, we have so many memories of the one we loved so much. Memories that will always live within our hearts. From the members of CFTTUS organization, the board members, and the names are listed. I would like to present this to the family, just so that something you can keep, so our dearly beloved sister will never, never be forgotten. I know it's very difficult to lose someone, someone you love, someone like Sandra Cutting. Listening to the previous speakers, this is not something that I wanted to say, but how many hours in a day did Sandra have? I have 24 hours, and I couldn't do half the things that she was doing in 24 hours. Working until 7 o'clock, getting home, take care of Miracle, cooking, studying. Where did she find the time? How did she do it? By God, whatever Sandra did, she always, always, always mentioned God. I first met Sandra when she was at the LA Carnival office. There would be meetings and I would see Sandra there. I thought that was a full-time job. She was dedicated. She was just helping Marie Keller with the LA Carnival, making sure that Carnival was going right. She would be on the streets with the parade, directing the bands. Until a few years later, she called. She said, "Vince, I don't like the type of costumes they're wearing on this carnival. I want to have my own band, my own costume band." I said, "Well, what are you thinking about?" "See, I want something with more clothing, with more color." I said, "So you want something a little more conservative?" She said, "Yeah." I didn't hear from her. 2 days later, she called me. She said, "I'm going to have my own band. We are going to be conservative masqueraders." And the following year, she brought her band out with her costume, and she was one of the largest bands at the LA Carnival. And for that, I want to applaud. Right now, in the islands where Carnival is being held, they are trying. They are trying to see if they can get people to wear more conservative costumes. Sandra attended all the events for nonprofits, for any bus ride you want to see, Sandra would be there. Sandra would help me sell tickets. For Marcus B. Entertainment, whenever he produced a comedy show, I would be selling tickets. Marcus would call me, "How are you going with the tickets?" I say, "I think I need a few more." He said, "Marcus, Sandra helped me sell some of those tickets." She always spoke about Marcus, and Marcus always spoke about her, because she said, well, Marcus always said when he first came to California, one of the first Caribbean people he met at the bank was Sandra Cutting. And they've been friends ever since. She was always supportive. Sandra was always there to compliment, to thank, and whatever she did it with people in mind. When she first started the Barbados Association of Southern California, before that she was with the Barbados Association of California. And the Barbados Association of Southern California was formed. And I was the DJ for the Barbados Association of California. And she was there. Sandra came with a flyer. She said, "I would like you to announce my event." Now, I am the DJ for the other organization, which she just left. And I'm looking at the flyer. I am making an announcement for her from the organization which she just left. I went ahead and I did it. And someone, a friend of mine, came and said, "How could you do that?" I said, "Sandra is my friend. Marcel Greenwich and the other companies, they are my friends. I can't take sides here." Then I told Sandra. She said, "Don't worry about it. I already told Marcel about it." That's the type of person. She was a woman of class. She just didn't give me that flyer to make the announcement without discussing it. I introduced Sandra to my daughter. I told her and my daughter, on the side, she does talk about families and help families with helping themselves after retirement and putting themselves in a good position and time of death. Sandra met with my daughter. The next thing I knew, Sandra attended meeting. Sandra started taking the classes. Sometimes I would call Sandra, "How are you? I'm studying." This is why I can't understand where she found all this time. The next thing I know, Sandra said, "I got my license to help people again." I introduced Sandra to Marilyn Lloyd, who would be feeding the homeless on Thanksgiving. She found out about this when we presented Marilyn with an award for her community service. The following day, she called. "How can I be involved in helping Marilyn with the feeding?" Sandra was always thinking about helping others and always wanted to compliment people for what they have done. When she started with the organization, she called me. She said, "I will be picking your brain. I want to get this organization going." I said, "Sandra, the first thing you got to do is find a good printer." And she started with Minuteman Press until today. And the programs you are looking at, is the program that he did. Before I leave, those of you who have one of these, I am going to call the first letter, and you all can say what the S is special, A, articulate, N is nice, D, dedicated, R, religious, A, amazing, S-A-N-D-R-A, Sandra. Thank you, family.
Thank you very much, Vince. Thank you. We work together very closely, so I do understand your heart is full and much to say. Miss Donna Edwards, are you here? Longtime friend. Please put your hands together and receive Miss Donna.
Thank you very much. Give praises to God for strength and for grace. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of a saint. And I'm holding a journal in my hand that I began when Sandra called me on March 13th and told me what she was told by the doctors. And I started keeping the journal as a tribute to journalize her journey, because I'm a cancer survivor and I expected Sandra to come through. So I've come to realize that God heals in two ways. He will heal over here, or he will heal, take you home. And right now, Sandra is resting in the arms of God, totally healed. Totally healed. To the family, they have dragged me in as a family member. Cindy still calls me Auntie Donna, with much respect. But I must say, my name is Donna Patricia Wright. I give back that name, Edwards, a long while ago. But Sandra, when she pencils something in, she keeps it like that. And I'm a Guyanese by birth. I am a citizen of the U.S. by naturalization. And I'm connected to the Barbadian society community because my patriarchal grandfather is from Barbados. So I am connected in more ways than one. And through Christ, we are sisters in Jesus Christ. So I'm connected. I stand here to give comfort to you and to let you know that the God of all peace and the God of all comfort be with each and every one of you. It is a difficult time, and we will have moments that we will cry and we will laugh and we will cry and we will laugh. And the grieving process is something that is going to go on and on, but it's going to dilute in certain ways. And we, I can speak for myself and others, are going to be right there. I first met Sandra over 38 years ago when we were both members at Church of God Pentecostal Inglewood, and where I'm still a member. And over the years, Sandra has proven herself to be a fierce, committed person. One fun fact about her, when she was over the youth president and the members were not doing as they should, she fired the entire, remember that, Bishop Young? She fired the entire youth department. And she carried on because that's the type of person she is. I always tell people, if you want something done, get a Caribbean person. Once they're committed to it, we are committed to it. And I thank God for that. But our relationship was founded there. And it's continued over the years where we share sad moments, happy moments, fellowship together, do different things together. Amen. And even though she moved on to another church to fellowship, our relationship is still very much intact. And when she called during the process she was going through, I would answer whatever she needs. And when I couldn't do it because I was dealing with something, I recruited someone else to fill my spot. So Cynthia Oliver, thank you for filling in and taking Sandra to her appointment. We're standing here in Women's Month where we celebrate the achievements of women over the years. Some of them are very visible, some are not visible. But today we can celebrate with a hand praise Sandra for all she is, for who she is, for what she has done, and for knowing that she's able to bring people together for a better purpose. So can we just give Sandra a hand praise on today? Sandra is a treasured gift, a committed person to task with a passion. And she is an influencer in her own right. I say that because once you work with Sandra, you will want to be efficient because she doesn't tolerate mediocrity at all. So you have to do well when you work with her. Sandra has a high capacity regarding family. Very connected. Families are right up high there with her. And she celebrates when she gets together. So the family knows of that. Most important about Sandra is her firm foundational faith walk with God. A love relationship with unwavering trust in God that we witnessed from March 13th until February 27th when I stand there at her bedside and saw my friend transition. She never lost her faith. Yes, yes. She never lost her faith. Yes. She never, never lost. Yes. She never lost her faith. She trusted God.
Yes, God.
She trusted God.
Yes, God.
She lost her faith. Takeaway from Sandra is that love God with all your heart, with yes. all your soul, with all your might. Love family. We need family. And whenever you can do good for someone, do it. Whenever you can encourage someone, do it. And always stand firm on what you believe, not wavering. Doesn't matter what anybody else say. To the family, continue to walk in the legacy. Sandra has lived our eulogy. Continue to walk and live out her legacy. And I give God the praise and glory And Pastor Charles, I want to tell you, Chase, I want to tell you something. With everything else I see happening, we need to talk because we need to do a book about Sandra and turn to a movie. You mean, it was my idea, so I get 10% of it. Thank you, man. God bless you. Thank you.
Duly noted, duly noted. I know that there are many of you who would also like to have words, but of course the program is limited, but there is going to be space for you to offer your thoughts and your well wishes at the repast later on this afternoon. So if there are any more of you who would like to have words that are not on the program, you can do so downstairs this afternoon at the repast. Please receive First Lady Donna Moore with a tribute from Kingdom Life, King's Dominion Life Church.
I give honor to God, who is the head of my life. And I thank him for this opportunity to be here for my sister's celebration. And you all are here because of who she is and who she was. Amen. So thank God for you. I stand before you. I have double duty here, so I'm going to make it really quick and brief. I have some letters and resolutions to read. The certificate of resolution for Sandra Patricia Cutting. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord, Revelation 14:13. In his own and for his own purpose, our God, our Father, called the spirit of his beloved sister Sandra Patricia Cutting home to be with him throughout eternity. We have assembled today to celebrate her homegoing. We are grateful to God for the life, lived service, and dedication given on the battlefield of the Lord. Though there is sorrow, it is not hopeless sorrow. We acknowledge that our Father God is God who does all well. So we trust and accept his sovereign will when we reflect on the spirit-filled walk of our dear sister and friend. We know that she is the recipient of many great promises. To the family and friends, we give our heartfelt condolences and prayers to you. Continue to lean upon the strong arm of the Lord, who is able to give comfort and peace in the midst of this difficult time. Precious in the sight of the Lord is his death of his saints, Psalms 116:15. A copy of this resolution shall be given to the family, and a copy will be kept in our church records, given this day, March 23rd, in the year of our Lord, 2024. Dr. T.A. Moore, pastor and founder of King's Dominion Life Center. There's also a letter from Dominion Alliance Pentecostal Churches from Bishop Darren C. Johnson, presiding prelate. To the family and sister Sandra Cutting, greetings and salutations in the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ. It is with very heavy heart that we receive the announcements of her heavenly transition of Sister Sandra Cutting. Our thoughts and prayers are sincerely with the entire family. Sister Sandra, a priceless jewel in the body of Christ, is now resting from the life journey of kingdom work. We do not sorrow without hope. With our hope, we await glorious appearing of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. For the trump of God shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we are alive, shall be caught up to meet him, the Lord in the air, live forever. This is from Bishop Darren Christopher Johnson, presiding prelate of the Dominion Alliance of Pentecostal Churches in Norfolk, Virginia. Bless God. Now I'm going to read some tributes that the family has written to their mom, their sister, their aunt, their grandmother. So please indulge me, because this is their time that they want to do this tribute to them. Amen. Tribute from daughter Cindy. I love you. There is so much I want to say to you. There are not enough hours, minutes for me to say. I stopped breathing when you took your last breath. I dropped to my knees and started to call on God. But then I felt a sense of joy come over me, knowing you were at peace and suffering no more. I could hear you saying your favorite refrain, "To God be the glory." I smile now when I remember you doing that. I know you are praising God all day long. The incredible faith you had through everything you had been through, your faith and love for God never wavered, Mom. And Mom, I will continue to keep him first in my life, no matter what I go through. Love, your baby girl. A tribute to our beloved mother and grandmother. Though you're no longer with us, your love and guidance continue to shape our lives every day. Your warmth, wisdom, and kindness remained etched in our hearts forever. We find solace in the memories we share and lessons you taught us. You'll always be our guiding light, shining brightly in our thoughts and prayers. Rest well, Mom. With all our love, Zachary, Avery, and Miracle. Tribute from granddaughter Sacred. Thank you, Mima. Did I say that right? For being so loving and creating a space where I was able to talk through my emotions whenever I felt alone, scared, and anxious. I truly cherish the time we were able to spend together. I will miss you every day for the rest of my life. I love you, Mima. May you rest in peace. Cuts, tribute from Claver. Cuts, we have known each other for 53 years, and now my best friend is gone. We have been through so much, but thanks for always being there for the kids and me when we needed you. You're gone now, but I will never forget you, always in my heart. Now, would you indulge me? Can we just pay a tribute and honor this great woman of God, this woman of faith, who is a mother, a sister, a grandmother, friends? Can we give her a great applause? I think she deserves it. This woman of faith, can you stand to your feet? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I think she deserves it. I think she worked hard. She stood the test of time, not wavering. A lot of people are up here saying she did not waver. She did not. A woman of faith. Hallelujah. And she trusts him to the end. She was such an inspiration to me, and if I've learned nothing else but that, continue to hold on to your faith. And she told me, sis, you have nothing else to hold on to but your faith. So we love you, sis. We love the family. We will continue to pray with you. God bless you.
Thank you so very much. Very well said. Please direct your attention to the screens where we'll have a video presentation at this time, if it's queued up.
Should stay, I would only be in your way, so I'll go, but I know I'll think of you every step of the way. And I will always love you, will always love you, you, my darling.
Come on, put your hands together. It's beautiful. Before Bishop Moore comes with the preaching of the gospel, we'll receive Miss Keisha Hall with one final selection. Please come. Put your hands together as she comes.
I'm going to minister the song, Great is Thy Faithfulness. This was my aunt's favorite hymn. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassion, it fails not, as thou hast been, thou forever wilt be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hands have provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Summer and winter and springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above, join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy and love. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hands have provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Pardon for sin and the peace that endureth, thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide, strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine,
with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hands have provided. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
Come on and stand on your feet. Everybody standing, please. Put your hands together and please receive none other than Bishop Dr. T. Allen Moore, who is the preacher for the hour. Come on and put your hands together.
The Lord be praised. While you're standing, let's continue to bless the Lord. Put your hands together. As we honor the Lord, He is good, and His mercy endures forever. And while you're standing, let's give Sandra a hand one more time. Let's bless God for the life that has been lived. Amen. You may have your seat in the presence of the Lord. We certainly honor the family and friends, co-workers, everyone that is in the room. We offer our condolences to the family. Sandra was a great part of our church. She was a woman of God that was straightforward. She didn't cut corners. You knew how she felt because she told you. Amen. We bless God for the life of Sandra and for the life that she lived. And for all of you that have gathered here to celebrate this amazing life. Though there is sorrow, the scripture declares, it is not hopeless sorrow, as we will miss her and we will miss conversations and the memories and all those things that make her as dear to us as she is and was. But it's not hopeless sorrow. We have good memories of our dear sister. So I'm twofold this morning. I'm honored to be able to stand on her behalf, but I'm also hurt. I would so much rather, as I know many of you would, that this honoring her today, she would be sitting here to hear us give tribute to her. But I believe that she is with the Lord. The Bible says to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And so she's in the audience in heaven, looking down upon us. We salute her today. We salute her life. We salute her legacy. To the family, we love you. We're praying for you. And We know that God's hand, the Bible says, weeping may endure for a night, but it's joy that comes in the morning. Amen. Just before, and I promise you, I'm not going to be long. The time is far spent, but I do want to just make sure that we honor if there's any other clergy, elders, ministers. We certainly want to give honor to them. I know in the room are some friends, Dr. Hope Harris, I believe you are. If you're here, just please stand if you will. Sandra touched many different areas. Pastors Michael and Dr. Sandra Withers are here. Amen. Bless the Lord. Bishop Dr. Young had to leave. But any other elders, ministers, pastors, if you're in the room, we want to acknowledge you today, and we bless God for you. If you're here, would you please stand? We bless the Lord for you. And we are grateful to our brother, Pastor Gregory Chase, who has led us thus far, done such a wonderful job. Amen. He and I have been talking several times over the last few weeks, and I'm grateful. We also want to honor Pastor Thea Butler as well. Amen. I just want us to know that Sandra touched many areas, not just a few, amen, but many areas. And so to you and you that have gathered here to celebrate her life, we salute you in Jesus' name. And we pray the Lord's covering over and upon you as you go throughout this next little while. We will, in whatever way, be a support to the family as much as we most possibly can. We love you all. I want to, just for a few moments, just call your attention to this verse of scripture. I also want to acknowledge our musician, Brother Ripley. Let's thank God for him for keeping the flow. I would, if you would just stand just for a moment as we read the scripture. Amen. And I'm reading out of the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter number 1. And there is a few verses there, just a few, that I want to read, and then you may take your seats as I pray. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, beginning at verse 1, and it reads like this: Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, by the will of God, and Timothy, our brother, unto the church of God, which is at Corinth, with all the saints which are all in Achaia. Grace be to you, and peace from God our Father, and from the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort, who comforteth us in all of our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble by the comfort wherewith we ourselves are comforted of God. For as the sufferings of Christ abound in us, so our consolation also aboundeth by Christ. And whether we be afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation, which is effectual in the enduring of the same sufferings which we also suffer. Or whether we be comforted, it is for your consolation and salvation. Last verse. And our hope of you is steadfast, knowing that as you are partakers of the sufferings, so shall you also be of the consolation. You may have your seat in the presence of the Lord. Father, we honor you and we bless your name. We thank you that you are the God of our souls. We thank you that you are pouring in the oil even now. You are covering us. We lift up the family, God, and we thank you that you are pouring in the oil. We thank you now, Father, that even in difficult times, that, Father, you will pour in the oil. We bless you now, Father, that you bring comfort, that you bring peace, that you bring consolation. Even now, even today, we lean upon you. We rest upon you. We rest in you because you are our God and our keeper. And Father, today I pray now just for the next few moments that you would speak to your people. Touch hearts in this room, we pray. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Amen. Clap your hands if you will. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. I just really just want just a moment, just a few moments to remind us of the fact that we are to be a comfort to one another. I want you to say these words with me, if you will. Let's help each other through this. Say that again. Let's help each other through this. As the Apostle Paul writes here to the church at Corinth, he writes, for the purpose of bringing comfort and consolation. And that's really all I'm here to do. I promise you, I'm not going to be long. But I want us to recognize those of us that have gathered in this room, those of us that have come to celebrate the life of this great woman of God, this saved lady that loved God and loved God's people. That now as she has departed our presence, and though we will miss her physical presence, we are admonished according to the scripture that we are to bring consolation one to another. This is the time not to walk in regret, but to be reminded of the love of God and the peace of God, and God's power to be able to bring us comfort. How many of you know that the Lord can bring you comfort? Y'all quiet. He can bring us comfort. He can console us. He is able to give us his strength. And this is what the Apostle Paul, as he writes to us, and as we jump to verse 2, he says, grace be to you and peace from God our Father. It is the peace of God and the grace of God, God's unmerited favor that the Apostle Paul seeks to release to us as we have gathered here today. It is the peace of God and the grace of God. The anointing of God's grace, his unmerited favor, but most of all, to be able to have peace. This is why the scripture declares that weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. I want to remind us that though we will have moments of sorrow, though we will have moments of disruption, and though we may have moments where we won't know what to do with the ball of emotions that is taking place, let me remind us that the scripture comes to console us and to remind us that though you may be weeping at night, you have been promised that joy is coming in the morning. I just want somebody to just lift one hand and say, I'm going to feel joy in the morning. I just want you to know that it does get better from here. I'm not telling you that we won't have moments where we are weeping, where we won't have moments of even possible depression. I need you to understand that. But the scripture declares to us that joy is coming in the morning. And I'm almost in my seat. But I want you to know that the Apostle Paul has come to console us. He has come to speak peace to us. And it is actually through the mindset that, as we have read these verses, that just for me to summarize, that when I'm experiencing my moment of peace, my moment of consolation, when my emotions are intact, I can now get with the person whose emotions are all over the place, who's feeling upset and broken, who is having a held down head. Come on, somebody. I need you to understand that it is at that moment when we bring peace one to another. This is why I have declared to you today, let's help each other to get through this. Will you just grab somebody's hand and say, we're going to get through this together. Come on, I told you I'm just about in my seat. But can we stand all over the room and just tell about two people that we're going to get through this together? Come on, y'all ain't standing. I need you to stand up. Come on, just tell somebody, we're going to make it through this. I know we may feel weak a time or two, but God's going to help us to make it on through this. God's going to give us what we need to be able to turn the corner. Come on, I need a few people in here that know God and that know that He can make a way out of no way. That even with tears in my eyes, and even when I'm dealing with a difficult season, the Lord's going to help us to help each other. Come on, tell your neighbor, I'm here for you. I'm going to help you make it through. I'm going to help you get through this. The Lord is touching you right now. I need somebody to clap your hands and begin to give Him praise. I'm done. I've been preaching a long time. I don't need to do much more, but I want you to just stand. Let's stand. To the family again, we're going to help each other to get through this. We're going to help each other to get through this. We're going to pray through this. We're going to power through this, not of our own strength, not of our own power, but we're going to power through this with the strength of the Lord. He gives us strength that even with tears in our eyes, we're able to make it through. Grab somebody's hand standing next to you. Grab a hand, grab a hand, grab a hand. We thank God for His grace. We thank the Lord for His mercy. The Bible says the mercy of the Lord, it endures forever. And the last time I checked, forever meant forever. So His mercy endures. The mercy of the Lord. The peace of the Lord. The power of the Lord. The presence of the Lord rests upon us as we stand in this room today. Peace of God, the rest, the quiet, when the phones stop ringing and the food stops coming, we need the peace of God to be with us. When the phones stop ringing, all of that stuff, we need the peace of the Lord. Jesus said, "My peace I leave with you. I leave it with you." Not ordinary peace, not peace as the world gives, but his peace. God's peace. Peace that passes all understanding. Today I speak again the peace of God, the rest of God, the presence of the Lord. Go with you to your homes. Be with you in times of weakness, times of difficulty. Peace of the Lord. Father God, we thank you. For every hand that we hold, we squeeze joy. We squeeze your presence, your power, your peace, your favor. Thank you, Father, for what you are doing even now. Thank you for your touch. For we receive this hand that we touch right now as your touch. And we thank you now that you give strength where there is weakness. You give power where there is powerlessness. And we thank you, God, for everything that you will do. Thank you for the life of Sandra. We are here to celebrate and to thank you for allowing her to be in our lives for whatever short time or long time. Thank you. We say thank you. And we bless your name. We give you the glory, for we know that you are sovereign. We know that you can do exceeding abundantly above all that we may ask or think, according to the power that works within us. We decree this and we declare it in this place now. In the name of Jesus, we love you, we thank you, and we bless your name. In Jesus' name. Come on, let's give the Lord a praise right there. Give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Come on, we honor him. We honor her by honoring him. Hallelujah. Come on, come on. Just 10 more seconds. Give him the glory. Give him the glory. Hallelujah. At this time, we're going to turn the service over to our funeral attendants for them to take us the rest of the way. And then we would ask you to receive the benediction in just a few moments. God bless you.
Any instruction? Okay. You will be under the direction of the funeral directors. They have asked that you not greet the family as you come to file past the casket that you just proceed on. If you have a blue lapel ribbon indicating that you are a member of the Barbados community, the closest, where's Sister Lorna, the closest that we're going to get to an honor guard is we're going to ask if you have a blue ribbon, if you'll find a place, and if you would be gracious on the way out before the casket comes, to allow the first person on the row to make sure that that person is part of the Barbados community with a blue ribbon all the way down on both sides before the casket, as the casket is taken out. So after you file, please come back. And Miss Lorna, this is as close as we're going to get to an honor guard on the way out. Does everybody understand what we're saying? But in the meantime, you'll be in the hands of the funeral director, and they will give guidance as to which row comes first, all right?
My friends and family, my prayer has always been for us to all see the kingdom. To God be the glory. I am resting now, awaiting that great reunion. Please do not be sad or mourn for me, as we know death is part of our earthly journey. Remember that whosoever believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life. We know this earth is not our home, because we have God's promise to see eternity in heaven. It was my pleasure and truly an honor to serve him on this earth and serve my Barbadian and Caribbean communities. Clavier, my daughter, my son, and my grandchildren, Avery, Miracle, and my sunshine sacred, I love you. You made me a proud mom, grandma, and made life worth living. I have prayed for you and Irvine, to my sisters and brother, Anne, Margot, Michael, and little sis Jeannie, I love you. You guys have been my rock through these times, praying for me and keeping me lifted. My spiritual siblings, Donna, Tina, Cynthia, Pedro, Greg, Peggy, and Vince, I love you. To my nieces, Chantel, Neil, Kimberly, Kiana, Auntie loves you. My great niece, Valentine, Caitlin, Auntie loves you. To my God kids, I love you and stay blessed. My brothers and sisters-in-law, stay sweet and keep God first in your life. To my friends and co-workers, thanks for the good times and all the laughs over the years. I pray you reflect on the joyous times and may our memories keep you in peace. To my church families, thank you for loving me and my family. Thank you for allowing me to serve you. Thank you for helping us and helping me fulfill God's mission and purpose in my life. Thank you for caring and supporting me. I pray I made a difference and had an impact on you and the way you did me. May God wrap our loving arms around you and grant you favor and peace until we meet again in that great get-up morning. Your mom, grandma, sister, aunt, and friend, Sandra Cutting.